and welcome to the Map Framework tutorial video for Map Axis and Map Cockpit. In this video, you will learn what features are included in the Axis framework, what gets imported, and the required modifications to fully integrate the framework into your application. The Map Axis framework comes with a single axis implementation that can be easily repeated for more axes. Detailed alarm integration with MapAlarmX is built in. Basic commands, along with manual and automatic modes, are included. Map Cockpit comes pre-configured and ready to run. And lastly, the optional Map View frontend includes a faceplate to perform basic commands on each axis. As time goes on, additional features may be added to the Axis framework. Be sure to check the help file of the latest version to see the full list of features. Note that the Axis framework depends on also having the MapAlarmX and Map Recipe frameworks imported into the project. The steps to import a map framework component are described in the overview video at the top of this playlist. If you haven't already watched that video, please do so now. As mentioned, to use the Axis framework, you must also import the AlarmX and Recipe frameworks. Therefore, in this section, you will see the necessary files for AlarmX and Recipe in the project as well. After import, a machine control package will be added to the logical view, which contains an Axis template package as well as an appAxis1 package. The Axis framework is designed in such a way that the main Axis control code within the Axis template package is reused for all axes that you add. This makes it easy to update the overall process for all axes simultaneously. After import, one axis, appAxis1, is set up and ready to run. Here you can see that four of the appAxis1 files are references back to the Axis template package. Any additional axes that you add will reference these same files as well, so that any modifications made to the axismanager.var, axisstatemachine.st, changeConfiguration.st, or recipe.st files within this package will apply to all axes. Let's take a closer look at what comes in the Axis Manager task. The axismanager.st file contains the general map function block handling and calls all actions. Next, we have the local type and variable definition files. The axisStateMachine file contains the state machine used for all axes. This is used for powering on, homing, manual or automatic mode, etc. The simulation control file contains supporting code for simulation. Add your code as needed for the simulation environment. The Axis control modes file contains the programming that is specific to each axis. This is where manual and automatic mode are programmed. Manual mode is set up for basic jogging to start out. Automatic mode by default is empty and must be programmed according to the application. The recipe file registers axis variables to the recipe system. You can register additional variables here if you'd like. The manual command file is used to define which commands correspond to manual mode, in which case this function returns true. Edit this file accordingly. The automatic command file is used to define which commands correspond to automatic mode, in which case this function returns true. Edit this file accordingly. Lastly, the change configuration file contains the supporting code to be able to change configuration settings at runtime. Modifications to this file are typically not necessary. Also included in the Axis packages are the localizable text files for Axis information and Axis alarms. If you imported the MapView frontend, then relevant content files are included in the framework package within the pages package. You will need to assign the Axis content to an area on the page within your visualization. The localizable text required for the HMI is included within the mappFramework texts package. Moving on to the configuration view, an appAxis1 package gets added to the mapMotion package. Here you see the axis configuration file and the virtual axis configuration file because by default, the first application axis is configured to be virtual. If you plan to run the axis on physical hardware and not in simulation, then add a drive to the physical view. In the drive configuration, set the axis reference to the map link from the single axis configuration file. Then delete the virtual axis configuration file. The map cockpit configuration file gets added to the map cockpit package automatically. a modular OpenCUA default view file will be added to the connectivity package. The TMX files used by the Access framework will be merged into the TMX files for target list and the text configuration. Some users and roles are added to the corresponding files within the user role system. All default user passwords are 123, capital A, capital B, lowercase c, and should be changed after importing the framework. If you imported the MapView frontend, an access package will be added to the MapView package, which includes all binding and event binding files necessary for the access framework. Lastly, in the CPU configuration, a few things are changed as well. If your user partition is less than 256 megabytes, the value is increased as such. If OpenCUA is not yet enabled, this will be enabled for you, as this is required for Map Cockpit. After importing the Access framework, take care that your task class 1 cycle time is 20 milliseconds or less. In addition to the required modifications mentioned previously, there are some optional modifications that you may want to consider. For example, you may want to add more axes or rename App Axis 1. For more details, refer to the corresponding section in the help. The map access content can be viewed immediately after project installation via the framework demo page in MapView. To utilize the access faceplate for manual mode, you must be logged in as either admin, operator, or service role. To demonstrate this here, I have also imported the MapUserX framework. The default administrative user is admin with default password 123, capital A, capital B, lowercase c. After logging in, you can perform basic operations like powering on, homing, jogging, and moving. Automatic mode right after import is empty, and therefore the auto tab does not yet impact the axis. And with that, we conclude our overview of the Map Axis framework. Please feel free to check out the additional Map Framework tutorial videos within this playlist.